Episode 2409, Love More When It's Easier Not To.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo. Staring at a stop
sign, watching people drive. Happy, happy day. It's a beautiful day in the neighborhood, and I hope it's a beautiful day in your neighborhood. It is Relationship Builders Day, and I want you to focus on your marriage, especially when it gets tough. Today is a special day. You'll find out more. Love more when it's easier not to. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already had the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple Strategy, Everyday Solutions to Live, Love, and Impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. You know, today is a very, very special day. It is Relationship Builders, but it's all about love. And I want you to think about this as we go through this as to how you want to look back on your marriage in the next 10 years. Okay, think about that. So if marriage was effortless, everyone would do it. However, it's through the challenges and storms that your love grows. Do what's hard. Love more when it's easier not to. Would you say that your marriage has been as pleasant as eating a piece of cake? Oh, tasty. I would like a piece of cake now. But for me, I got to tell you, it's been more like eating rocks. And I don't even know what rocks taste like, except that marriage has been far from easy. Marriage isn't easy. And I would much rather eat a piece of cake all the time. Now, it doesn't do great for my hips or my bouteille, but it does great for my taste buds. A lot of us get into relationship because we're aiming for just the taste, the satisfaction, saying we can do it, but very rarely are we willing to put in the work. Today, my husband and I celebrate 28 years of marriage and almost 32 years of being a couple. That's a long time together, more than half my life. In fact, I've been with my hubby longer than I was with my parents. Huh. Probably lucky for them. In fact, if my mom's listening, she's probably like, thank goodness she left when she did. No, I'm joking. I love my mom. We have an incredible relationship, but I also know that she supports, and my dad did too, of course, supported us going out and creating a life of our own. And that's what's important. We create our family. We come together. But when we do that, right, it takes work. Well, when you tell somebody or somebody asks you, you know, how long have you been married? And you give them an answer. People are quick to judge when you tell them how long you've been married when celebrating an anniversary, as if marriage for us was easy and with no hardships. But we have to think about everything in marriage, not just make assumptions that you've been married so long because you didn't have problems or struggles. Far from the truth. Any couple who has been married for greater than 10 years, especially the ones over 25 and up, will tell you that it was in the struggles that created the love bubbles. You know, the whole thing, right, about, you know, it's worth the fight because the makeup's that much better. I'm not going to say and encourage you to go have a fight so the makeup will be great, because you should be able to make up without a fight. But in all of this, what I am telling you is that love isn't easy. Marriage is far from easy. Nothing worth having is easy. And marriage is the same, right? You want an incredible marriage. You have to be willing to put in the work and love more when it's easier not to. That is your kiss to keep it simple strategy. Love more when it's easier not to. I want you to imagine a roller coaster. I know we go from love to roller coaster, but no, seriously, I do. People have a love of roller coasters. Have you ever been to a theme park? Which of the lines are the longest? The roller coaster lines. Okay, maybe unless if you're in Disney. But for the most part, everybody's in line for the roller coasters. There would be no lines if it wasn't for the drops or upside down all around twist. There wouldn't be. In order to have an exceptional roller coaster, you have to have the valleys with the hills, or there would be no thrills. Marriage is the same way. You have to take what's on the hill and bring it to the valleys. But everybody just wants to be on top of the hill. Everybody wants it easier. Everybody wants to say, you know what? That's where I want to be. I want to be them. But in order to get to be them, the successful people, couples on the hill, you got to go through all the valleys. And what you learn in the valleys, you got to take to the hill. And then when you go back in the valley, you got to take what you learned on the hill down to the valley and bring it back up again. And guess what? It gets harder and harder and harder. But it also gets better and better and better. Love more when it's easier not to. I want to give you three areas in generalization that I want you to really consider in this. Remember, I asked you at the very beginning, I want you to think about what we're talking about here and what you want to see when you look back 10 years in your marriage. Because when I look back 10 years in my marriage, actually I have to go to about 11 and a half. Our marriage wasn't great. It was falling apart. I never thought my marriage would look like that. Never. And I don't use that word lightly. That never crossed my mind. I didn't daydream about it. But it happened. And it was tough. I have more learning lessons during that time than I've had in my entire lifetime. But I'm telling you, every bit of second that I put into that marriage, that I also put into myself, it has exponentially blessed me 11 and a half or so years later. So, love more when it's easier not to. Number one, listen intently. This cannot be repeated enough. We are not listening. We're just hearing things in the background. We're just hearing rumblings of wah, 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 wah. Remember Charlie Brown's mom? I think it was Charlie Brown's mom. You hear it always in the background. Wah, 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 wah. That's sometimes what I think we think about when our spouse talks. It's like, oh, she's saying it again. Oh, there he goes. Just blip, 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 blip. Really? That's so disrespectful. You got to respect your spouse, so you got to listen intently. I can't remember exactly what my husband and I were doing. I think it was last weekend. Oh, I know what it was. He was in his office, and his office is basically off of the hearth room in the kitchen, and he can see into it. Now, we are very blessed. When the house was built, our interior walls actually are also insulated. That's very rare. You get the outside walls, you know, that are actually the outside, but your interior walls, your dividing walls, usually are not. Ours are, so it's great for soundproofing, and it's not 100%, you know, soundproof, but you open that door and you're like, oh, wow, it is definitely a difference. That's fabulous. Now, I say all that because you know me, I love to talk, and I have a very big mouth, and I say it with woohoo. Yes, that's part of who I am. But I also have had to learn how to tame it down a little bit, right? And my husband was in his office working. I'm in the kitchen doing something. The kids are around too. We're having conversation. And actually, I think it was during the week. I don't think it was last weekend. I think it was earlier this week, actually. Anyway, long story short of it, he's working, and when he works, he has to focus. It's what it is, what he does, and that's fine. So we all try to respect that when dad's literally working, not just in his office, but when he's working in his office and doing stuff that he needs to get done for his patients, then we do our best to honor him in that and keep our voices down, especially me, because yes, my voice loves to project, and I love to talk on top of that. Well, I'm in there, we're talking. Well, later on, it was like the next day or two passes, and he says, "Hun, I just really need to focus, but your voice." And I said, "Honey, I wasn't talking really loud." Now, understand, that's coming back to where we were just before here. And he goes, "I know," but he goes, "When you speak, I want to listen." Drop the mic right there. If you have a spouse who's willing to listen all the time, guess what that really means? You're truly being heard from the inside out. The heart is being heard too, because you're present. But unfortunately, we are living our everyday with our spouse, and we're just kind of treating them like, oh, it's a responsibility. Do you want to have a lifelong partner that's just a responsibility? Let's be real here. Love more when it's easier not to. Listen intently. Number two, forgive faster. I know it's easier to slam the door in somebody's face, point the wrongs when they're completely wrong, because it's like, aha, score, my point, bonus points. Yes, I love it. But then when life is really happening and you're interacting in your everyday, how can you make it to the next moment if you're lugging along all this baggage with you? If you're keeping score all the time, oh yeah, when he did this like 5 years ago, it's amazing. I talked to so many people. They can almost verbatim give me exactly where they were, the date, the time when their spouse truly really messed up big time. They're like, I got to remember that. Remember for me, 11 and a half years or so ago, you know, I asked you to look 10 years back, what you want to see in your marriage, how you want to see it. For me, I have to go back in 11 and a half years. That's when my marriage was absolutely chaos. All HE double hockey sticks broke loose. I never thought I'd be in the position that I was in. If people were in my shoes, I guarantee you over, and this is not at all stretching it, I would say over 75 to 80% of the women, if they were in the exact same shoes that I was in, they would have walked out. And it may actually be higher, 90%. It's well over 50%. That's how crazy it was. But you see, if we are so quick to sit there and be Santa Claus for all of our mistakes that our spouses make, then you're not giving any gifts to your marriage at all. You're just being the Grinch that stole your marriage. Is that really what you want? Love more when it's easier not to. You got to forgive faster. And yes, that may mean that you forgive more. But again, you're not keeping score. Listen intently. Forgive faster. And finally, number three, hold often. We may give kisses. We may say, I love you. But where's the embrace every day? And I'm not talking about, oh yeah, I sleep with him every night. I'm not talking sexual intimacy. I'm talking about holding each other. Holding each other's hands. If your spouse is doing the dishes, you go up and you give them a hug and you just hold them there. And it doesn't have to be for a long time. But you see, when you hold someone, there's what? Human connection, flesh to flesh. That is intimacy. That is what draws you closer. Yes, the bonus is the sexual intimacy part. That's awesome. But a lot of people hide behind that because it's easier to say, okay, I'm going to just go get it on and then I can forget about it. Made him happy, made her happy, and now we're done. But what happens in the everyday? You still got that sack of gifts? Are you being the Grinch that stole your marriage? Hold often. If you're driving, if you have a moment and you're in a safe place and you can do it, hold each other's hands. Now, my husband is one where my hands, because we live in a city and there's always traffic, it seems like. And when we drive and we do our road trips, which we love, my hands are a lot of times, both of them are on the wheel. So instead of holding my hand, he holds my arm. It's so sweet. But he's holding me. Maybe for you, if your husband's driving, you can just put your hand on his shoulder. Maybe you can rub it just a little bit, but say, hey, babe, I'm here. You're not saying that, but that's what your action is portraying to your spouse. But most of the time, we're not doing that. We get up in the morning, maybe you get a peck on the cheek or the lips, depending upon how your spouse is with, have you brushed your teeth yet? Are you clean? Are we ready for an embrace? I'm not sure. So you have to meet all these right criteria. But when do you embrace? What if every morning you woke up and instead of saying, oh man, I'm going to dread today. Oh, the kids, and you start yelling at them. What if you were to go to the other side of the bed and just hug each other? What do you think that would do for your marriage? Love more when it's easier not to. listen intently, forgive faster, and hold often. I don't want you to give up on your spouse, and definitely don't give up on your marriage. Having a lifelong partner is very rare. So be that rarity in the world. Love more when it's easier not to. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a beautiful day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.